Hey everyone, so here we are back in Aliens Colonial Marines, and I've just completed it last night, and you know, I can't justify completing it unless I make a video about everything wrong with this game. And I'll try and talk about the few things that it does actually have going for it, which the few things which aren't actually all that bad, but man, yeah, this is not a good game, which obviously everyone already knows, and honestly, there's not really much point in me making this video. I realize that, but you know, let's get into this anyway, shall we? Right. Okay. So let's go through the settings menu. Now the controls for the most part are fine. This obviously supports a controller, although I haven't actually played it with a controller at all because it's a first person shooter. So I've mainly been concentrating on mouse and keyboard. As you know, if you saw my video of my previous. My first 2 hours playing the game, then you'll have noticed that I had to rebind a couple of the controls just because having the grenade launcher on F is really stupid. And, well, in my opinion, it's really stupid. And honestly, it's my own fault for sort of not remembering that E was used and not F. But anyway, I moved that to V, and that seemed to solve that issue. And I think I moved something else to F. I can't actually remember what it was. It might have been the... well, let's have a look, actually. What did I move to F? I rebound some of the keys anyway. There you go. I moved melee to F instead of V, which actually helps quite a lot. And that was much better for me. Anyway, that doesn't actually matter. But yeah, the controls, they're fine. The mouse actually feels fine. The sensitivity is smoothing and all that. Even though, you know, I've had it on. Usually I turn this sort of stuff off, but it was fine. I didn't actually notice any problem with that. Nothing really about that bothered me. So anyway, yeah, I turned off the film grain in the when I did the first video, and I've never turned it back on. I've never really felt like the need to have that back on. So I can't actually speak to whether that's decent film grain or not, but I turn it off. And the rest of the stuff, I mean, it's all all the way up here, but it didn't really make the game look all that good, really. I mean, the game looks okay for about 3 or 4, maybe 5 years ago, but it doesn't look like a title that came out in 2013, I'm going to be honest. And obviously the sound effects. The sound effects are all actually pretty good, and music and all that. The voice acting is bad. The voice acting is really bad. I actually think that the voice acting by Hicks is actually worse than the non movie characters. Lance Henriksen does an okay job. I mean, he usually plays Bishop in like all the games and films and everything that he comes back in, and he seems to do a pretty consistent job. He acts as the android Bishop really quite well, so there we go. Let's get into playing some games, shall we? Like I said, I completed it, so let's go through this, shall we? Where are we looking here? Gotta look at where the UI is. Let's go for Battle for Sulaco, shall we? Yeah, let's do that. Right, let's go there. And I'll just leave it on that. What's advanced options? Let's see what we've got here. Network mode offline, game mode campaign. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I gotta say this right here and now, actually. This game seems to be a single player game built around all the multiplayer features. It's almost like they built all the multiplayer stuff first and then coupled together a single player game on top of the multiplayer sort of core. Because all the rank up stuff, the way the missions are all laid out, like single player, multiplayer maps and sessions, it's all very strange. But nah, I guess it is what it is. Right then, so let's see what else is bad about this game. So this game, here we are back at the beginning. I was actually trying to skip all the beginning stuff, but whatever. So I actually played this before. Watching any of the pre-release stuff again that was released like around the actual release of the game, I actually avoided watching that just to try and get a fresh perspective on this. And you know, as I said in my video, I sort of stand by everything I said in the in my first couple of hours video. It's not a terrible looking game, but it does look like more like a budget title. It doesn't look fantastic. But in areas it does, it's very inconsistent. Like some areas, like, I know glass sometimes looks pretty good, lighting looks pretty good, but then some areas look really, really bad and really terrible. So it's really inconsistent, shall we say. It's like they did half the work, like a few years before they sort of put together the rest of the game to sort of finish it off. and get it ready for release. That's kind of what I'm saying, I guess. But yeah, it's inconsistent. Let's just say that. It's inconsistent. The audio, for the most part, is pretty good. Like I said, the voice acting is not great. But for the most part, the audio is okay. The audio is not bad. And the characters, I know, you never really get to know any of the characters. You never really get any more than other than their Marines. This game's a very strange game. Like, story-wise, I don't like the story at all. It seems like you do some cool stuff when you're on this locker and then you go down to the planet. You seem to do some pretty cool stuff there. And it's nice to see the areas of the movies, which are sort of how things were left after the movies and things. It's nice to see them all sort of, I don't know, rendered in game, and they're reasonably accurate. And like, you've seen the cryo tubes ejected and the burn marks next to the one cryo tube, for example, for Newt. You know, that's all kind of cool if you're a fan of the films, but it's all essentially means nothing. I think as it goes for story and environments and all that, I think Alien vs. Predator 2 way back when actually did a better job by not being anything to do with the films, but still being in the universe. I actually think that did a better job. Like, story-wise, I don't know what the story is about. I don't see what the point is of the story. It doesn't really have a conclusion. You just get off the planet, and the alien queen dies, and I don't know. There's just no real point to it. It seems like a fan-made game in some ways. And that's insulting games which are made by fans which are actually really good. Such as the Sonic fan remix was actually really good for how far they actually got with it. But yeah, it's just it's a very weird, very strange story. It's not good. It's not good. It's not good at all. I really don't care for it. I like being in the environments from the films and seeing the bits from the films, but yeah, the story is utterly terrible. And then of course, I had to do, of course, is go and watch the pre-release stuff from when the game was actually being released, from like 2012 and early 2013, it would have been all 2012. And I watched that, and then I compared it to this game, and I'm like, yeah, this was a massive downgrade, wasn't it? Let's be honest. It sort of brought back all those feelings from way back then. From way back when this actually first came out, and I was just utterly gobsmacked, and I feel that way again. Like, you know, this game is just nowhere near that that level that they were showing off. Like, even the movements of the troops and everything was all very sort of well animated and human looking, and in this they just run around like multiplayer characters. They run around like multiplayer bots. As I said, this is kind of, it just feels like the whole single player game just feels like a single player version of the multiplayer. So yeah, it's such a strange game. It's such a strange game. In a way, I'm kind of glad that I've played it, because now I've played a really bad game which I didn't really want to play. I did kind of want to play it. I did actually kind of want to play it because I wanted to experience what the game was actually like, and what it was all about. Especially with fresh eyes, especially after this long, after the whole debacle with the release and so on. I know, I'm actually kind of glad for the experience, if anything. At least I've kind of reminded myself what a really bad game is like. I've got quite a few of those to play through right now, so I've got another one to play right after this, which I'm kind of looking forward to playing. And it'll be, you know, I cover a lot of games that I like. I played a lot of games and made videos on a lot of games that I already liked and sort of revisited for that reason. And I'm kind of glad that I've revisited a game that, or rather, played a game, not revisited, played a game that I didn't like. I'm making this video on it because it's just well, I just feel a whole lot better getting all this out there, because this game is just not good. It starts off, here's the thing, just before we go and do this cutscene with this guy, it starts off pretty well. I was kind of interested and I kind of intrigued to seeing where things were going, especially considering it's using the movie licenses and movie characters and the areas from the movies and the same ships, the same planets, all that sort of stuff. And then about halfway through, and it's pretty short. I haven't really got a problem with the length, probably because it's bad, and probably because I just actually wanted to complete it. So this being short wasn't so much of a problem. There we go. Let's do this thing. So I didn't mind that so much. Where's my gun? Let me just get my gun and do this. Wow. Alright, let's just get this scene here. I think they just want us to walk over here. Right, there we go. It is. I just wanted to get that out of the way. Right. Yeah, about halfway through, this game just kind of, I don't know. It kind of lost me. It becomes very samey. The wailing Yutani soldiers are sort of boring to shoot through again and again and again. And I died so many times in this, and I feel a little bit embarrassed to admit that, because this game is bad, but I still died like so many times now, and I feel like some of that is a lack of skill and a lack of. I always used the pulse rifle. I did try some of the other weapons, and other than the SMG, a lot of the other games, a lot of the other guns didn't seem to be worth it. The shotgun's pretty good. I didn't mind the shotgun, but nothing seemed as effective as the SMG or the pulse rifle here. Which, actually, let's get to the SMG. Which is, it's basically a smaller pulse rifle, so it's not all that much different. And the other weird thing as well, I just kind of mentioned this thing. You can pick any of the weapons at any point, but you can only carry two? That just seems like a really weird system. I mean, I feel like I'm not complaining about it necessarily, because it's nice to have access to all the weapons. And, I mean, some of these are unlocked as you go through it, but you always get so many guns available at the beginning, so it was just so strange. It's just such a weird system. So I don't know. Weapons. Yeah, I don't know if I was actually supposed to be using a certain type of weapon in certain areas or whatever, but a lot of them just didn't seem as effective. Shooting the aliens kind of just becomes a bit of a chore, because they at first sort of seem to die pretty quickly, but later on they just seem to soak up damage. And it doesn't matter how much you've upgraded your pulse rifle or whatever, they just don't seem to drop as easy as they do early on. The game's pretty steeped in atmosphere early on, but then later on it just sort of becomes more of a very, very standard corridor shooter. And then there's the bugs, and there's so many glitches and bugs. It's kind of hilarious. Oh, brilliant, this time again. This is the area where we usually die a lot. Right, so yeah, the bugs and glitches. For what is essentially a very, very simple first-person shooter, with some level-up mechanics granted, but I mean, that's really just multiplayer, let's be honest. there are so many bugs, there are less bugs in more complex games like Mass Effect and Dragon Age, and, you know, and I was going to say Fallout, but no, Fallout's pretty buggy, to be fair. But in a way, you can kind of understand that, because, you know, that's actually a pretty complex RPG with open world and so on and so forth. You know, I don't want to make excuses for Fallout, because that really was a very buggy game, and that really needed to be fixed. But yeah, I mean, it's so buggy for such a simple first-person shooter, linear game. It shouldn't have this many bugs. There's so many little glitches, and I felt like the music just stops for some reason. That's a very small glitch, but still, it's a bit odd. These guys, sometimes you just pass straight through them. Other times you don't. Sometimes they get in the way and you can't walk past them. But then, like I said, other times you just walk straight through them. It's so weird and irritating and frustrating. The game's, quite frankly, it was just frustrating to finish. It really, really was. you know, the music's kind of cool. That's sort of a positive. The music's very similar, if not quite the same as the music from the Aliens film. Which is, again, it's ever so slightly off, and I wish it was actually just kind of the same music. Like, if you're going to use that music, just make it the same, because it's ever so slightly off. And that's actually kind of more irritating. It's almost like they got a sound alike, so they didn't have to pay licensing fees. That's what it kind of sounds like. I wish it was the exactly the same music from the game. Okay, is this bug still here? Yeah, that's a good one. So in my first 2 hours, when the aliens just ran straight through here, this is glass, but we can just walk right through it. So yeah, I think this is going to be a real short video, just about me complaining about this terrible, terrible game. I'm sure I'm missing stuff. I'm sure that I'm missing things, which is just irritating. All I will say, actually, is that the end boss with the Queen, that was, you know, you're expecting a big epic fight with the Queen, maybe with the power loader, and that's not what happens at all. That is not the end boss. The end boss is like this weird hide and seek game. And pressing buttons, it's pretty bad, and it took me probably way too long to actually do it, just because you're not exactly sure what the pattern is, if there is a pattern, or whether it's just more about you actually shooting at the Queen to get her to come to you, or whether it actually is a pattern. I was confused. I don't feel like a lot of it got explained, and that's the end of the game, and the game just seems to end. It seems like there should be more after that, and you're on this ship, which presumably is for the Voyou people, but that doesn't seem to matter. You're just there, and it ends like that. And it's a very odd game. I don't like it at all. I don't recommend it, obviously. I don't think anyone would buy this at this point. You know, if you want to remind yourself what a really bad game's like a bad game which isn't early access, or a bad game which isn't a triple A title which is just broken on release, because this I gotta say that again, this isn't a triple A title, this is a budget title. Interesting thing, a friend of mine actually reminded me about this. He happened to say that, you know, if this looked as good as the previews, if the graphics were as good as the previews, but the story and everything else was still the same, it still would be a bad game. That's what's funny about it. It would just be a good-looking bad game, which we've had plenty of those as well. Oh, and there we go, I'm dead, just like that. Granted, I was being surrounded by aliens there, but there we go. Anyway, you know what? I think we're going to leave it there. I think there's not much point in me continuing on, because it's just going to be me complaining more about this. Any positive stuff? Let me think. Any positive things left? You know, actually, there was a couple of good sections in this game. There was this one point where you're in the sewers and you don't have any guns, you haven't got any weapons at all, and you have to sort of navigate. It's kind of a stealth section, but I quite like stealth in games. I quite like stealth games, so that, you know, would make sense for me. And you kind of got to creep around these aliens which are blind and they can only hear you, so you've got to be very, very sort of quiet and slow in your movement, and I actually kind of like that. That was a different change of pace. It wasn't just shooting Wayu guys or aliens, so that was pretty cool. I quite like that. Quite like that quite a bit. And I'm sure there was another section like that actually. Well, I suppose, you know, I got to give credit to the pacing, is that it's not all just shooting aliens, getting surrounded by aliens, shooting Wayu guys. Who are needlessly, by the way, the way you guys, they're needlessly bullet spongy. They have pinpoint accuracy from a trillion miles away. They can take you out wherever they are. It's yeah, not great. I found fighting them to be more annoying than the aliens, and the aliens can get pretty annoying as well. And of course there's the AI of the aliens and everything as well. But yeah, the one good thing I've got to say about it is that one section in the sewers. And at least the fact that the pacing is not too bad. At least they have some sections where it's not just get surrounded by aliens, take them out, just constantly fighting aliens away you guys. That was pretty good. I was quite happy with that. But towards the end, it definitely becomes just kind of a shooting fest. And yeah, it's just kind of bad. It's just kind of bad. I will say one thing, at least I only played like £2, something like that for it. I am kind of glad I only paid £2 for it. So, thank God for that. If you just want to play a really bad game for whatever reason, you know, it's like watching a bad movie. It can kind of be entertaining itself. I will say some of the bugs were very entertaining. They kind of kept me laughing. But, I think I said I wouldn't mind playing this again just to get all the collectibles and stuff. Yeah, I'm not going to be doing that. I don't think I can play through this game again. It's kind of actually causing me physical pain to play through it again a little bit right now. Although I will admit, at least it's the opening sort of couple of levels, which are actually not bad. I actually kind of like those levels. They're not terrible. And getting down to the planet's not bad either, at least at first. But the planet really wears thin. Right, I think that's me done on this game, guys. This is not a great game, obviously. I feel like I'm saying this, and I feel like there's absolutely no point in me saying that because everyone already knows this. But you know, it was still worth trying out. It's entertaining, at least for a couple of hours to begin with, and then kind of, you know, if you're a big Aliens fan, of course, and it just gets really, really old and really samey and very boring, just boring later on. So I think that's me done with this game, guys. Please, you know, leave a comment and subscribe if you want to see more videos in future. Hopefully more timely videos and games which are actually good and more recent than this game. And I will see you again next time, guys. Thanks very much for watching, as always, and I'll see you next time. Alright, guys, just a quick thing to add on to the end of this video. I almost forgot about this one bug, which is just fantastic with this game. And if you're going to have this bug in any game, man, it's got to be this one, doesn't it? So when I quit this, Steam automatically launches it every single time, and the only way I can get it to stop is if I go into Task Manager and kill Steam, and then AVP. ACM. Then ACM actually stops working and actually stops. And then you can go back into Steam and actually do what you want to do. It's hilarious that this is the game that when you quit it, it automatically launches back up. It's like, no, you're not done yet. It's just really cracked me up. It's a terrible bug, and there doesn't seem to be any real fix for it. Having a quick look on the Steam forums, there doesn't seem to be anything there for it, but that kind of really cracked me up. Yeah. So, you know, if you do get this game, especially on Steam, just watch out for that one. That's a doozy of a bug. Alright, guys, so, yeah, actually, really the end of the video now. Thanks very much for watching, I'll see you next time.